Yo, homeboy. Where you been, man? We've been looking for you.
Yeah, we ain't seen you around Burger World lately. So where you been, huh?
Oh, you know, around.
Want a piece of pizza? Think I got an extra piece around here somewhere.
No, that's okay, thanks.
Yo, ding dong, man. Ding dong. Ding dong, yo.
No, thanks, really.
Yo, eat this, man. It's good for you.
I'm not really very hungry right now.
Hey, man, what it is with you? You on some kind of diet? Is that what they teach you in that little sissy school of yours?
Back off me, man. Back off.
The question is, are you fat or what?
Leave me alone.
I said, are you fat?
Get off me, man. Stop it.
You ain't down with us no more. You ain't fat. You ain't fat.
You ain't fat. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing.
As I walk through the valley where I harvest my take a look at my wife and realize she's very plain. But that's just perfect for an Amish like me. You know I shun fancy things like electricity. At 4:30 in the morning, I'm milking cows. Jebediah feeds the chickens and Jacob plows. Fool, and I've been milking and plowing so long that even Ezekiel thinks that my mind is gone. I'm a man of the land, I'm into discipline. Got a Bible in my hand and a beard on my chin. But if I finish all of my chores and you finish thine, then tonight we're gonna party like it's 1699. We've been spending most of our lives living in an Amish paradise. I churned butter once or twice, living in an Amish paradise. It's hard work and sacrifice, living in an Amish paradise. We sell quilts and discount lights. Him well, cause I'll be laughing my head off when he's burning in hell. But I ain't never punched a tourist even if he deserved it. An Amish with a tool, you know that's unheard of. I never wear buttons, but I got a cool hat, and my homies agree I really look good in black. Fool, if you come to visit, you'll be bored to tears. We haven't even paid the phone bill in 300 years. But we ain't really quaint, so please don't point and stare. We're just technologically impaired. There's no phone, no lights, no motor.
Useless as JPEGs to Helen Keller. Cyrus bathes and crunch numbers like I do. The culinary team of the spreadsheets. I'm all printed out on my bedsheets. My new computer
got my rocks, but it was obsolete. That's over.
You say you've had your desktop for over a week. Throw that junk away, man. It's an antique. Your laptop is a month old. That's great.
And you think you can erase your
way of paperweight. My digital media is right protected. Every file inspected, no viruses detected. I beta tested every operating system. Gave props to some and others I dissed them. While your computer's crashing, mine's multitasking. It does all my work without me even asking. Got a flat screen monitor 40 inches wide. I believe that yours says Etch a Sketch on the side. In a 32-bit world, you're a 2-bit user. You've got your own news group, all total loser. Your motherfucker knows when you try to send a fax. Get your CPU in a box of Cracker Jacks. Play me online, well you know that I'll beat you. If I ever meet you, I'll control all the leads you want.
Bye. We've been together for so very long, but now things are changing. Oh, I wonder what's wrong. Seems you don't want me around.
You don't love
the
me anymore.
The passion is gone and the flames died down. I guess I lost a little bit of self-esteem. That time that you made it with the whole hockey team. You used to think I was nice. Now you tell all your friends that I'm the Antichrist. Oh, why did you disconnect the brakes on my car?
That was
fine. That kind of thing is hard to ignore. Got a funny feeling you don't love me anymore.
Maybe I should let him sing.
I knew that we were having problems when you put those piranhas in my bathtub again. You're still the light of my life. Oh, darling, I'm begging, won't you put down that knife? You know what? Even think it's kinda cute the way you poison my coffee just a little each day. I still remember the way that you laughed when you pushed me down the elevator shaft. Oh, if you don't mind me asking, what's this poisonous cobra doing in my underwear drawer? Sometimes I get to thinking you just don't love me anymore.
Oh, I should let him sing.
You slammed my face down on the barbecue grill. Now my scars are all healing, but my heart never will. Set my house on fire. You pulled at my chest hairs with an old pair of pliers. Oh, you think I'm ugly and you say I'm cheap. You shaved off my eyebrows while I was asleep. You drilled a hole in my head. Then you dumped me in a drainage ditch and left me for. Way before, honey, something tells me you don't love me anymore. Oh no, no, got a funny feeling you don't love me anymore.
He lost the love of his life.
We'll be right back.
This song came out.
Well, I suppose that proves
have become dinosaur shit.
Just be there.
Dare to Be Stupid. But Devo did this song.
Yeah. tank should be bought around here at any price. Why do lawyers have them $68 million? I hate you.
Well, this morning is good for getting a lot of paper signed for Mr. Crazy.
I'm doing that when I left here 2 hours.
Love, and I have to use the self-service pump. Oh, honey, if say, darling, I'd rather have my blood sucked out by leeches. Leeches. Shove an ice pick under a toenail for two. I'd rather clean all the bathrooms in Grand Central Station with my tongue than spend one more minute with you. Yes, I'd rather jump naked on a huge pile of thumbtacks, or stick my nostrils together with crazy glue. I'd rather dive into a swimming pool filled with double-edged razor blades than spend one more minute with you. I'd rather rip my heart right out of my rib cage with my bare hands. Then spend one more minute with you.
What a weird album. Weird album.
Down in the booth? He's ready. Okay, here we go. Loosen up camera two. Cameras one and three, that's fine. Five, four, three, two. Cue lights, all music. Right.
Now we bring the studio and today's contestants. This is Mr. Millard Snufkin from Carbondale, Illinois. And this is Mr. Leroy Finkelstein from Brooklyn, New York. And this is Alfred Yankovic from Linwood, California. These three people will compete today on Jeopardy! You didn't win a 20-volume set of the Encyclopedia International, a case of turtle wax, and a year's supply of Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco drink. But that's not all. You also made yourself look like a jerk in front of millions of people, and you brought shame and disgrace on your family name for generations to come. You don't get to come back tomorrow. You don't even get a lousy copy of our home game. You're a complete loser.
Thank you.
Niagara Falls. Nice.
Yeah. to reiterate the name of this movie is Spy Hard. They call it Spy Hard. You're watching Spy Hard. It's the theme from Spy Hard.
This is Christmas at Ground Zero. Did I time that right?
Thank you. hours away now. I'm sure you're all looking forward to it as much as we are.
You might hear some reindeer on your rooftop, or Jack Frost on your windowsill, but if someone's climbing down your chimney, you better load your gun and shoot to kill. So it's Christmas at Ground Zero, and if the radiation level's okay, I'll go out with you and see all the new mutations on.
Baby,
do my
música solo.
No devil you've done. Lonely Tylenol, not a banana baton. No X in Nixon, of Stone be not so. A Geronimo, no minor ego. Naomi Amon, a Toyota's a Toyota. A dog, a medic, in a pagoda. UFO tofu, we panic in a few. Uzi rat in a sanitary zoo. Got a red nugget, a fat egg under a dog. The hang of salami, I'm a lasagna hog.
And the only one that pertains to Star Wars, the saga. The saga begins.
A long, long time ago, in a galaxy far away, Naboo was under an attack. And I thought me and Qui-Gon Jinn could talk the Federation into maybe cutting them a little slack. But their response, it didn't thrill us. They locked the doors and tried to kill us. We escaped from that gas, but met Jar Jar and Boss Nass. We took a bongo from the scene and we went to feed to see the Queen. We all wound up on Tatooine. That's where we found this boy. Oh my, my, this here Anakin guy. Maybe Vader someday later. Now he's just a small fry. He left his home and kissed his mommy goodbye, saying soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Use him hitting on the queen. Oh, he's
ride back to Naboo, 'cause Queen Amidala wanted to. I frankly would have liked to stay. We all fought in that epic war, and it wasn't long at all before little Hotshot flew his plane and saved the day. And in the end, some Gungans died, some ships blew up and some pilots fried. A lot of folks were croaking, the battle droids were broken, and the Jedi I admire most met up with Darth Maul, and now he's toast. Well, I'm still here and he's a ghost. I guess I'll train this boy. And I was singing, my, my, this here Anakin guy. Maybe Vader someday later, now he's just a small fry. And he left his home and kissed his mommy goodbye, saying soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. We were singing, my, my, this here Anakin guy. Maybe Vader someday later, now he's just a small fry. He left his home and kissed his mommy goodbye, saying soon I'm gonna be a Jedi.
Yeah, pretty much hoping that I put it on the right side because I want more videos. Looks like I put it on the right side. Sweet.
Once in a while, maybe you will feel the urge to break international copyright laws by downloading MP3s from file sharing sites like Morpheus or Grokster or LimeWire or Kazaa. But deep in your heart, you know the guilt would drive you mad, and the shame would leave a permanent scar. 'Cause you start out stealing songs, then you're robbing liquor stores, and selling crack, and running over school kids with your car. So don't.
Do I even need a reason?
Oh, do I even need a reason? Oh,
back in there and put...
Even more than mine. Attracts every other pancreas in the universe with a force proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the distance between them.
Woo, 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 woo.
Don't you know you gotta flow, 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 pancreatic juice, flow, flow into the duodenum, won't you flow, 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 pancreatic juice, flow, flow into the duodenum, won't you flow,
insulin, flow, pancreatic juice coming from the islands of lung.
Yeah.
right, then your backups too. And the hard battle, anyone related to you. Virus alert, you need immediate food before someone gets hurt. Forward this message onto everybody. Soon, very soon, it will make all the pain feel off your bones. Put off the hickey, give your poodle a hickey, and invest your cash, your stock, in your own Disney thing. It will tie up your phone, making crank long distance calls. It'll set your pops back in an hour and start fogging the showers. So just trash it now, or else it will decide to give you a permanent wedgie. Legally change your name to Reggie. Even mess up the peak balance in your room. Look out, it's gonna melt your face right off your skull.
Look out,
and make your iPod only play Jungle Cull.
Look out,
and tell you knock knock jokes while you're trying to sleep.
Look out,
and make you physically attracted to sheep.
Look out,
steal your identity and your credit card.
Look out,
try you a warehouse full of pinkly guitars.
Look out,
spin cause a major rip in time and space, and leave a bunch of Twinkie wrappers all over the place.
Let's ride in some
virus alert. You need immediately before someone gets hurt. Forward this message out to everybody.
Virus alert.
You need immediately before someone gets hurt. Forward this message out to everybody. Warn all your friends, send this to everybody. Tell everyone, you know, tell everybody now. If you get infected, you'll wish you had never been born. So before we email your grandmother all of your porn, turn off your computer.
Make sure your power's down. Come on. Wow.
Wow, nice.
Thank you.
Alright, let's go for it. Ready?
That's a nice tone. Let's hear the floor.
Try it without the hi-hat kind of
going into that.
Telegraphing it, yeah.
Three, four.
Beautiful.
second section.
Acoustically, I might just have him turn the vocals way down or maybe even off. That way we can really lock into the beat better. Is that all right with you guys?
That's great.
That's good. You hear that, Tony?
Don't you know it's weasel-stomping day? All the little girls and boys love that wonderful crunching noise.
Oh, you haven't heard the new weasel sounds, have you?
I sued Coca-Cola, yo, cause I put my finger down in a bottle and it got stuck. I sued Delta Airlines cause they sold me a ticket to New Jersey. I went there and it sucked. Yeah! It...
Up the headache starting.
Strong.
just in the first two cycles to move to G minor. A little bit more, still feels a hair late. Actually, both F sections still feel just a hair lazy. Now, if you can split the difference, because as much as it was lazy now it's a little ahead. Lay it back just like another millisecond or two. That's feeling better. Let's lay back the first G minor section just a hair. Good.
Chess team. Only question I ever thought was hard. What do I like, her or do I like Picard? Spend every weekend at the Renaissance Fair. Got my name on my underwear.
They see me strolling, they laughing, and rolling their eyes because I'm so white and nerdy.
Just because I'm white and nerdy. Just because I'm white and nerdy. All because I'm white and nerdy. Holy cow, I'm white and nerdy.
I wanna bowl with the gangsters, but oh well, it's obvious I'm white and nerdy.
I'm just too white and nerdy.
Don't wanna be a Canadian idiot. real sport.
But no cigar.
Do I creep you out? 9 o'clock in the evening, watching something stupid on TV. I'm zoned out on the sofa when my wife comes in the room and sees me. And she says, is this behind the music with Leonard Skinner? And I say, I don't know, say it's getting late, what you wanna do for dinner? She says, I kinda had a big lunch, so I'm not super hungry. I said, well, you know, baby, I'm not starving either, but I could eat. She says, well, what do you have in mind? I said, I don't know, what about you? She says, I don't care if you're hungry, let's eat. I said, that's what we're gonna do. But first, you gotta tell me what it is you're hungry for. And she says, let me think, what's left in our refrigerator? I said, well, there's tuna, I know. She said, that went bad a week ago. I said, is the chili okay? She said, you finished that yesterday. I hopped up and said, I don't know, do you want to get something delivered? She's like, why would I want to eat liver? I don't even like liver. I'm like, no, I said delivered. She's like, I heard you say liver. I'm like, I should know what I said. She's like, whatever, I just don't want any liver. Well, I was gonna say something, but my cell phone started to ring. Now who could be calling me? Well, I checked my caller ID. It was just Cousin Larry calling for the third time today. My wife said, let it go to voicemail. I said, okay. Where were we? Oh, dinner, right. So what do you wanna do? She says, why don't you whip up something in the kitchen? Yeah, I said, why don't you? And then she says, baby, can't we just go out to dinner, please? I says, no. She says, yes. I says, no. She says, yes. I says, no. She says, yes. Oh, here's your keys. I step a little bit closer. Say, okay, where you wanna go? She says, how about the Ivy? Said, yeah, well, I don't know. I don't feel like getting all dressed up and eating expensive food. She says, Olive Garden. I say, nah, I'm not in the mood. And Burrito King would make me gassy, there's no doubt. She says, just forget about it. I said, no, I swear I'm gonna take you out. Then I get an idea. I say, I know what we'll do. She says, what? I say, yes. She says, what? I say, we're going to the drive-thru. So we head out the front door. Open the garage door, and I open the car doors, and we get in those car doors. My key in the ignition, and then I turn it sideways. Then we fasten our seat belts as we pull out the driveway. Then we drive to the drive-thru, heading off to the drive-thru. We're approaching the drive-thru, getting close to the drive-thru. Almost there at the drive-thru, now we're here at the drive-thru. Through line, me and her, cars in front of us, cars in back of us, all just waiting to order. There's some idiot in a Volvo with his brights on behind me. I lean out the window and scream, hey, what you trying to do, blind me? My wife says maybe we should park, we could just go eat inside. I said I'm wearing bunny slippers, so I ain't leaving this ride. Now a woman on a speaker box is saying, can I take your order, please? I said, yes, indeed, you certainly can. We'd like 2 hamburgers with onions and cheese. Then my wife says, baby, hold on, I've changed my mind. I think I'm gonna have a chicken sandwich instead this time. I said, you always get a cheeseburger. She says, that's not what I'm hungry for. I put my head in my hands and scream, I don't know who you are anymore. The voice on the speaker says, I don't have all day. I said, then take her order, and we'll be on our way. I wanna get a chicken sandwich, and I want a cheeseburger too. She's like, you want onions on that? I'm like, yeah, I already said that I do. Plus we need curly fries, and don't you dare forget it. And 2 medium root beers, no, just 1, we'll split it. Then I said, I'm guessing that you're probably not too bright. So read me back my order, let's make sure you got it right. She says, 1, you want a chicken sandwich? 2, you want a cheeseburger? 3, curly fries and a large root beer? Stop, don't go no further. I never ordered a large root beer, I said medium, not large. Then she says, we're having a specialized supersized you at no charge. Oh, oh. And that's all I could say was, oh, oh. And she says that there's something else that I really think you should know. You can have unlimited refills for just a quarter more. I say, great, except we're in the drive-thru, so what would I want that for? But she says, wait a minute, your voice sounds so familiar. Hey, is this Paul? And my wife is all like, no, that ain't Paul. Now tell me, who's this Paul? She says, oh, he's just some guy who goes to school with me. I sat behind him last year and I copied off of him in geometry. I said, I know a guy named Paul. He used to be my plumber. He was prematurely bald and moved to Pittsburgh last summer. He also had bladder problems and a really bad infection on his toe. And she says, Mr. Please, you can stop right there. That's way more than I needed to know. And then we both were quiet, and things got real intense. And then she says, next window, please, that'll be $5.82. So we inched ahead in line, moving paid for this show. I got a little bored, so I turned on the radio. Was getting a headache, so we both just sat there quietly for her sake. Then I looked at her and she looked back at me, and I said, I think you have something in your teeth. She turned away from me and then turned back and said, did I get it? I said, yeah, well, I mean, most of it, but hey, you know, don't sweat it. Then she said, how about now? I said, yeah, almost, but still a little. I can't believe there's no wallet! Wallet! And the lady at the window's like, well, 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 that'll be $5.82. I turn around to my wife and say, how much have you got on you? She just rolls her eyes and says, I'll pay for this, I guess. So she reaches into her purse and busts out the American Express. I hand it to the lady, and she says, oh dear, it's gotta be cash only. We don't take credit cards here. I took back the card and said, gee, really? Well, that sucks. And that's when I found out my wife was only carrying $3. I said, I thought you were gonna hit the ATM today. She says, I never got around to it, so where's your wallet anyway? And I said, never mind, just help me to find some change. Now the lady at the window's looking at me kind of strange. And she says, mister, please, we gotta move this line along. I said, now hold your stinking horses, lady, we won't be long. So I looked around inside the glove box and checked the mat beneath my feet. I found a nickel in an ashtray and a couple pennies and a dime in the space between the seats. Before long I had a little pile of coins of every sort. The lady counts it up and says, you're still about a dollar short. And now my woman's got this weird look frozen on her face. She screams, you know, I wasn't even really hungry in the first place. And so I turned around to the cashier again. I shrugged and said, okay, forget the chicken sandwich then. So I pick up my change, pick up my receipt, and I drive to the pickup window. Man, I just can't wait to eat. And now we see this acne-ridden kid about 16, wearing a dorky name tag that says, hello, my name is Eugene. And he hands me a paperback. I look him in the eyes, and I say to him, hey, Eugene, could I get some ketchup for my fries? But he looks at me, and I look at him, and he looks at me, and I look at him, and he looks at me, and I look at him, and he says, I'm sorry, what did you want again? I say ketchup, and he says, oh yeah, that's right, just based out there for a second, I'm really kind of burnt tonight, and then he hands me the ketchup, and now we're finally. Pull up.
This is a story about a guy named Al, and he lived in a sewer with a hamster pal. But the sanitation workers really didn't approve, so he packed up his accordion and had to move to a city in Ohio, where he lived in a tree. And he worked in a name for the congestion factory, and he played on the company bowling team. And every single night he had a strange recurring dream, where he was wearing leader hose and a vat of sour cream. But that's really not important to the story.
Well, the very next year he met a dental hygienist with a special attitude on her arm. But he didn't even doubt Jenny lost her number. Then he got himself a job on a tater tot farm, and he spent his life saving.
One day Al was in the forest trying to get a tail, when he heard the torture dreaming of a funny little man. He was caught in a bear trap and now set him free. And the guy that he rescued was grateful as could be. And it turns out he's a big chat producer on TV. So he gives Al a contract, and what do you know? Now he's got his very own weird Al job.
In the fridge.
Next up. Weird Al Yankovic, who first became known for his parodies of popular rock tunes in 1979 with his parody of a song done by the Knacks, which was called My Sharoma. And Weird Al rewrote it and called it My Bologna. It was recorded in a luxurious state-of-the-art acoustic tile men's bathroom across from his college radio station because they wouldn't let him in the studio. Last September, Weird Al performed his newest parody entitled Another One Rides the Bus. This was done live on the Dr. Demento radio show, with stations across the country carrying this program, reporting an overwhelming problem with listener response. Everybody turn their radio off. Here is Weird Al Yankovic, and the weirdest thing that Al has ever done is one day he took a tire off his father's car and he sucked all the air out of it. He has his partner John Schwartz with him tonight, and they have a song. I can't find the title here. What's the title of the song? It's Another One Rides the Bus. Here is Weird Al Yankovic. Here he is. Weird Al. Tell you, when he was a baby, his mother says, "What a picture!" His father tried to hang him. A little later in the program, a young lady named Krista Lauren will join us. She also does this kind of music, and I know you're going to want to stay up for this. Now, she'll perform what she calls the Space Shuttle Shuffle. It's only been 2 weeks, but she already has written a rock tune for the two guys that went to space and came back down. We'll be right back with more of our show from New York and Los Angeles right after we've been.
Thank you.
top. I don't know who he's trying to do there. Wow. And that is the last thing on there. Crazy, because see, Queen Amidala is behind him. Okay, so that's like 2 hours and a half of just pure awesomeness.